Hi, my name is Dennis Kuschel and I'm the developer of Mainor. Mainor is a thing-about computer that is built entirely from discrete CMOS logic gates. This means that it has no microcontroller and no CPU. The design is kept as simple as possible, which means that there is only one ROM and one RAM memory chip on the board. The computer doesn't even have an arithmetic logic unit. Other do-it-yourself CPU projects use the ALU74181, a large EEPROM-based lookup table or multiplexer. Mainor is much simpler. It only uses a single NOR gate for computations. This is where the name of my computer comes from. Now let's have a closer look to the board.
The board has a size of 10 by 13 cm. It contains an EEPROM for the microcode and user program. The microcode itself occupies only 9 kilobytes of the EEPROM. The 8 kilobyte SRAM is used to store CPU registers, the stack memory and data. An application program can also be saved here, which can either be loaded from the integrated EEPROM or uploaded via RS232. This is the EEPROM in which 8 application programs can be stored. The discrete 1-bit NOR gate is used for all computations, such as AND, OR, exclusive OR, addition and subtraction. With this single NOR gate, Mainor can perform up to 2600 8-bit additions per second. This is very slow, but still fast enough for most use cases, as we'll see later. The board has two I.O. connectors, which provide 8 digital inputs and 24 digital outputs. There is an RS232 connection on the board, which is used for communication with Mainor and for uploading programs. The UART signals are also available on the right I.O. connector. In addition, the right I.O. connector provides also an I2C and an SPI interface. These four chips form the I.O. interface. And the rest of the chips are used to form the CPU. Of course, with the help of the microcode in the EEPROM and the registers in the SRAM. Last but not least, the clock oscillator. I designed Mainor to run stably at 4 MHz. At this clock rate, Mainor performs 2600 additions per second and the serial port runs at 2400 baud. It turned out that most of the replicas of Mainor can also be clocked with 8 MHz. This doubles the number of additions per second and also increases the baud rate of the serial port to 4800 baud. This is the block diagram of Mainor. There's really nothing special on the board. A note about the LEDs. The LEDs are controlled by the microcode and indicate the use of the 1-bit NOR gate. I developed two expansion boards for Mainor. The first one, the calculator board, has 20 buttons and 8 7-segment displays. That this board, a simple pocket calculator with a vintage look, can be built with Mainor. The calculator board can be mounted on the Mainor baseboard so that the boards form a compact unit. Let me show you how well the calculator works. Mainor automatically detects the presence of the calculator expansion board and starts the corresponding firmware routine. Adding and subtracting numbers is very fast because the computation is done in the BCD number domain. The multiplication and division takes place in the binary domain, because this requires fewer addition operations. While the multiplication can be optimized so that only a minimum of additions are used, the division routine is always executed on 56-bit floating point numbers. This is why dividing numbers with a calculator is so slow. The second expansion board is more complex. It contains an LCD, 15 buttons, a loudspeaker, a real-time clock and a temperature sensor. Let's take a look under the LCD. Most of the available space is occupied by the sound generator, which is still very simple. Here is the real-time clock and the temperature sensor. The expansion header provides access to the I2C and the SPI interface. This expansion board turns Mainor into a real microcomputer, which is suitable for simple applications and also for playing games. Let me demonstrate. When the computer starts, the main menu appears. From there, you can load one of 8 application programs that are stored in the EEPROM. I am now starting the Minesweeper game. I also wrote a simple car driving game. Please note that the high score is saved in the EEPROM, so that your score is not lost after power cycle or reset. A And of course I also wrote the Tetris game for Minor. Due to the slow speed of Minor, programming this game was a real challenge. I didn't just write games for my new computer. I also wrote some tools, like this kitchen clock. Do you remember the melody that is played when the time is up? Now I'm showing you how easy it is to upload software to Minor. All you have to do is visit my website, choose the program you want to run on Minor, copy the text encoded program file into the clipboard, open the terminal program of your choice and switch on Minor. And when Minor says hello world, paste the content of the clipboard into the terminal window. Now you have to be patient, since it takes a while to upload the program with 2400 baud. Here we go.